today. No more stolen land. Join us, y'all.
We're standing here strong. Which side are you on?
We're standing here strong. Which side are you on?
We're standing here strong.
Which side are you on? We're standing here strong. Which side are you on? We're standing here strong.
Which side are you on?
We're standing here strong. Which side are you on?
My heart goes out to her. Also, last Last week here in Frisco, that's San Francisco for those of you who don't know, another man was killed. Luis Gongora.
I guess we'll go out.
Say his name! Luis Gongora!
Say his name!
Luis Gongora!
Luis Gongora! This is the only picture that they have released of him. He was a Mexican immigrant. He did not speak English. He did not know what the cops were telling him. Again, apparently, he had a knife just like many other police stories. The video didn't show exactly what happened like many other videos. You know, this is some nonsense. It is some nonsense. And it's gotta stop. That's why I'm here.
We are here not just representing people who are American citizens. This involves all of humanity. There are over 33,000 people that are kept in immigration facilities for coming to the United States to search for a better life. There are 2.3 million people incarcerated in the United States right now at this moment as we are here at this university. That is more people than some countries have in their entire population. Would make sure that these people and the community knows that San Francisco State University does not condone these violent attacks against our citizens and against all of humanity.
Hell no. Hell no, we don't condone that. And you know what? If you guys will allow me, I have something I want to read. It's from a longer piece that I wrote because it's called I'm Sick of This Shit. And I wrote it because I'm fucking sick of this shit. That's why you see me up here talking. Excuse me, you guys, but the situation is ugly in itself, right? Some real shit, I gotta get down to business. If you feel this, shut the fuck up and listen. There's some issues that got me bugging and got me thinking. Hop in the brown man's shoes and contemplate on all them killings. How many times you see the police and it crosses through your mind? What if tonight I get pulled over and I fuck around and die? Potentialities that's present in my life, no lie. They go ahead and kill us on the street and they don't hide. They don't try, I don't know why, to resolve the issues with no guns and no violence. It's a genocide in front of our own eyes. It's like to them it's just fun to scare us with them sirens. But all I hear is silence. No one wants injustice, but no one wants to fight it. But who can blame them? So for motivation, I had to write this. Just listen to these verses, they have a dedication. Luis Gongora, Mike Brown, Mario Woods, and Alex Nieto. There's many more, the list can go on forever. Now the verses can keep going, I can go keep going on this rant. But I got shit to do, we all gotta do this. So I can't.
You guys are all in the right place. That's right. We need some energy up in here. That's for sure. Look, let's be real. We're doing this to stop this. We want to put an end to this. And when I say the whole damn system is guilty, I want you to say the whole damn system is guilty. All right. 1, 2, 3. The whole damn system is guilty. 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 Remember, this is a National Day of Student Action to Stop Police Terror. So the whole main point is there needs to be a whole new radical student movement to stop police terror. So we're inviting the James Lick students to come and speak on why they're here. Why'd you walk out of school? Because we're the friend here to stop police terror.
Woo!
We organized this in less than a day. My friend Gabe and a girl named Janet, we started putting out flyers. We got out here without permission to the school, but we still did.
Yeah.
Because we care. Because we care about stopping this brutality. God bless America.
Nowadays, everybody says that the youth doesn't care about any of with this, and if they do, they'll just, like, walk out and ditch. But that's not true. We came here because we were motivated to. We came here because it's not right what everybody's doing. And we really do invite everybody to come and support this movement with us. And, yeah. My friend has a story, and her story is that a cop threw her brother on the floor right in front of her and handcuffed him right there, and she watched him go to jail like that. This was years ago, but it still hurts her very badly, and now he got deported and she can't see him no more.
That's some bullshit.
My name is Rafael from the Revolution Club, and I just want to say I'm out here because I am pissed off, like he was saying. I'm pissed off because every single day in this country, 3 people are killed by the police. I'm pissed off because every single day in this country, people of color, mostly black and brown, Latino, Native American, are thrown on the ground, are beaten, are tased, are pepper sprayed, are choked out like Eric Garner, are all too often murdered by the police. And then they come and they kill you twice, right? They kill you, and then they lie about it in the media. They say you were threatening them. They say you had a knife, you had a gun. We all know the bullshit excuses you asked for. Hell no. You believe that shit?
No.
You believe the story they told about Luis Gongora after they killed him?
No.
Or the story about Mario Woods? Say it straight up. We all saw the video. We saw it with our own eyes. Do your eyes lie? That was a straight-up execution squad that killed that young man. All right, I am sick and tired of it. I refuse to live in a country where the police have a green light to murder black and brown people. This has not stopped because we got our first black president. I'm sorry, but the killing has continued. The Department of Injustice has let these killer cops off every fucking time. All right, I'm gonna keep it real with you. Voting is not gonna change this shit. If it didn't change in the last 8 years, electing another Democratic president is not gonna change it. This today is the path of struggle. This is not the easy road. Vote. You know, go to the ballot box, pull a lever, donate $27 to the Bernie campaign. I'm sorry, that is not gonna cut it. These people that are running this system are not gonna change without a fight, okay? It's like Baba Vankian said, the role of the police is not to serve and protect the people, it is to serve and protect the system that is ruling over the people. How long are these killer cops gonna get away with this shit? As long as this system stands, okay? So what we need to do is we need to fight back, and we need to build up the strength to bring this system down.
Yeah!
All right? That's why I'm out here today, and I encourage you to get into the work of Baba Vankian, who's actually got a strategy for how we can bring this system down and a vision of a whole new system beyond this capitalist imperialist system that, yes, is destroying the environment, yes, is oppressing women, is oppressing our LGBT folks, is deporting and demonizing our immigrant brothers and sisters, and is murdering black and Latino people and Native people every single day in this country, and it's got to be ended. So join
no
us.
No more!
All right, no more!
No more!
No more!
No more! No more.
All right, so we're about to march in a minute. Are you guys ready to march?
Yeah.
Are you guys ready to march?
Yeah.
We're going to take this message all over the campus, and we're going to wake the students up. We're going to shake up this campus, and we need to challenge everyone out here at San Francisco State today with the reality of this genocide that is happening, like he said, right under our noses, and to challenge them to pick a side. Are you okay with it? All right, go on to class, it's all good. But if you're not okay with it, then you need to join us. You need to stand up.
All right, everybody, let's go ahead and go. Stand up and shout it. Don't be silent. Let's put a stop to all the police violence. Mike Brown said, don't shoot. Eric Garner said, I can't breathe. Let's put a stop to the killer police.
Let's practice a couple more of the chants before we go. All right. Michael Brown was college bound. How many more will they gun down? Michael Brown was college bound.
How many more will they gun down?
Michael Brown was college bound?
How many more will they gun down?
All right. If you're sick of the murdering police, get out of your classes and into the streets. If you're sick of the murdering police,
get out of your classes and into the streets.
If you're sick of the murdering police,
get out of your classes and into the streets.
Okay, let's change reality in police brutality. Let's change reality
in police brutality. Let's change reality in police brutality.
Let's change reality
in police brutality.
All right, this banner is about to go down there, and everyone get behind this banner, all right?
Let's do this, everybody. Through the spray of rolling, every revolution.
Wake up, stand up, be part of the solution.
Through the spray of rolling, every revolution.
Wake up, stand up, be part of the solution.
Chicago police.
Rise up, rise up, rise up.
Rise up, rise up, rise up.
think of us.
Freedom!
breathe.
I can't breathe.
I can't breathe.
I can't breathe.
Michael Brown says, don't shoot. What did Michael Brown say?
Don't shoot.
What did Michael Brown say?
Don't shoot.
What did Michael Brown say?
Don't shoot.
What did Michael Brown say?
Don't shoot.
I can't breathe.
Because this has a lot to do with students playing a role and being a part of
situations are and having a radically different world. So let's start. So let's do it together. Ready?
No more generations of our youth.
No more generations of our youth.
Here and all around the world.
Here and all around the world.
Whose life is over.
Queremos paz. This is for you guys. The children made it for you. We want peace in the community. So they are all for you. The children made this for you. So you guys can go ahead and see that we want to have a good relationship with you.
Okay.
But we need to work together because you have a chief that is not doing his job. And we don't want to be fighting you, but we need that guy to be fired.
Y le vamos a desear suerte a Cristina, a Ike, a Illich y a las personas que están haciendo huelga de hambre. Le decimos suerte,
suerte,
fuerza,
fuerza,
poder latino,
poder latino,
negro,
negro.
Así es. La policía la
The strikers?
No. I'm just here to support them.
Okay. And this is for not just one guy. I mean, it's for the whole movement,
about
right?
Systematic violence.
Yeah. Until Sir is fired.
And if
that's
Sir
the
doesn't
goal.
Get fired, asking Ed Lee to step down. He's responsible. So.
All right.
I think it's been 12 people since 2014. That's a lot of men. That's a lot of human beings, man.
Yeah.
It can't be once a month. It can't happen, you know?
Yeah.
Just recently, another occupation in served the community and not only saved the Berkeley Post Office from being sold to privatization, but it turned into a community switchboard, an organizing center for homeless people. So they decided after 17 months of people taking care of themselves, a Oh no, you're helpless. You're homeless, you're supposed to be helpless. But because of the fact that we continue to organize and we continue to rise off of our knees, they decided to come down and evict the post office as if we're going away. Well, guess what? We're not. My message today is to my homeless brothers and sisters. Do not despair. Let us both collectively rise off of our knees and tell Ed Lee, usted, asesino, bastardo, let us take care of each other. When we are on the sidewalks at 3 o'clock in the morning and we see another brother walking down the street in the rain without a blanket, give him a blanket. When you see another homeless person that is hungry, feed each other. To hell with their shelter. To hell with their soup line. To hell with their plans. And to hell with their leave. And to hell with the SFPD and their death squad. Because we are organized to take what we need. We are going to go back to our history of the 1930s and the unemployed workers movement, and we are going to rise. We are going to rise in anger. We are going to rise in the terms of mutual aid. We are going to rise in the terms of voluntary cooperation. And we are going to link arms, and we are going to take care of each other, and we are going to link with housed people, with employed workers. And together we are going to march down the street. And we are going to tell Ed Lee, Gustavo, Asesino, Bastardo.
Thank you, Mike Lee, for those words of inspiration and for sharing your story of what's been happening in the East Bay. We know that this is not a situation that is unique to San Francisco. Next up, we have Elaine, who is a minister and spiritual leader on the streets and camps of the city. She has been surviving these sweeps and police harassment since 2010, and she's here to share with us her perspective as well as what she believes is needed to end this violence and keep people safe. Please welcome Elaine.
Hello. Good afternoon, everybody. It's a shame to say that I am a citizen of San Francisco. This is not the city that I grew up in. This is not the loving city that I can remember. The way I was kicked out of housing, it was terrible, behind lies. And they said I couldn't pay my rent. I paid rent on time. It was filthy. The way it was taken care of, filthy. And I was addicted. When I was in the hospital, it was terrible. And I've been on the street since 2010. And I have multiple disabilities. I've had multiple things taken from me, stolen, put in their cars by San Francisco Police Department, by DPW. I've seen this with my own eyes. I've seen it with my own eyes. Things have been taken. And I had signs out what I do. I minister. I keep drugs off the street by ministering to drug addicts, pregnant drug addicts, women who are helpless when they think they're helpless. But we come together. It's more love. It's more love out here in the homeless. It's more love out here in the homeless areas than you see in the whole San Francisco. When I see people coming together as one, when we are hungry, when I got everything taken from me, everybody came together and donated me something, donated me clothes, blankets, food, because I was left with nothing. They took my medication. They took over the books that was very expensive. And I know they didn't throw those away. I know what they did with them. I'm not stupid. I wasn't born. I have plenty of sense. And we are not crazy out there. We know what they are doing. And they cannot shut us up. We have a voice, and it is time to rise up. We will not go away. We are not like roaches that you spray poisonous on and we just die. We will multiply and keep rising up because we are angry. We're tired of this situation happening. I have nightmares in my sleep, afraid of not the people but the police. Afraid of them coming in, taking me somewhere where nobody will hear from me again. And I fear this. My son is out here homeless, and he has to come, you know, when your mother is having problems, and he's fearing for my life. My husband is fearing for my life out here, for just be, for not by the people out here. The people are watching me. It's by the system, the police who are doing this. And things are being taken. I've seen this. I've seen how they just destroy ourselves and just like it's nothing, like we're garbage. We are human. I put my clothes on just like the mayor does. I put my clothes on like the police do. I take baths. I eat. I'm a very neat, extreme neat freak. I've gotten things together where everybody can find out how to way to dispose of their waste. These put garbage together, but they wanted to take the credit, and then they blame the things on us that when people from their houses came throwing garbage down here to blame it on us, they made all kind of chaos, and we get blamed for it. But number one, we are the ones cleaning up their garbage, so we won't get blamed for it. But they don't show you guys the truth. If you would come down there to see what it's really like, I have been asked if people can come down there and spend a night to see what really goes on. But we are suspicious because the police are doing things to try to make up lies on us, and it's not right. But we are, like I said, we are having a voice now, and we are speaking out to you guys that we are human, to come and hear us, to come see us, come talk to us. We have lots of love to give. I have lots of love to give. I love to help my brother and sister. I love to help the little ones that come down there. I minister day and night. I pray day and night, not for just the homeless, but for everyone who is like me, for everyone who is in need. We are not cannibals. We are not crazy people. We have plenty of sense. We have education. You'd be surprised the people that you will meet down there. It's a city of homeless people, a city of intelligent, very intelligent people.
Woo!
We are human beings. We can form America if we want to.
That's right.
Because we are so intelligent. Number one, because we have a love what America's supposed to stand on. We're supposed to love our brother, love one another as your mother loves a child. We have to learn how to do that again. We have forgotten the way of what is right. We have forgotten the way of what good things are. What kids could come out and play without worrying about the police or somebody shooting their brother in the back for something that they were not doing. You can't even pray over somebody by them thinking all you're doing is I can't go into a store because I might look homeless and the police are following me all over around asking me, oh, what are you doing? I'm in here making groceries like anybody else. I can't use the customer's bathroom like anybody else because I'm homeless. It's not right. I'm a human being and I love doing good. Give us a chance to give love. Give us a chance to tell the truth. Don't shut us up. Because if you try, we're going to get louder. And we're going to get more angrier. And it's not right to back us up in a corner because we will bite. And we will bite with love. That will probably make you go out to love someone else. God bless you guys.
Thank you, Elaine, for sharing your story with us and for all of your amazing work in the community, reminding us to love each other and take care of each other when this corrupt system is trying to prevent us from doing it. Next up on the mic, we have Kenshin Tomoshima. He is an artist and curator of Clarion Alley and formerly homeless. He spent years as a street-based artist in San Francisco and is also a survivor of the sweeps. He is now inside, and as a neighbor and formerly homeless San Franciscan, he continues to feel the impacts of the years he spent surviving police violence and harassment. Please welcome Kenshin.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for coming out to show your support. Like she said, my name's Kenshin. I'm one of the curators and muralists here at the Clarion Alley Mural Project. A little over 2 years ago, my rat master Splinter and I were camping on Shotwell in a tent, painting murals out of my backpack, and we've since gotten our low-income housing squared away. Being housed has allowed us to escape the constant economic oppression, profiling, and harassment and violence, not only from the San Francisco Police Department, but from the recently transplanted techie usurpers and local business owners that cater to them. Housing has also enabled me to rescue more animals and focus on becoming a better painter and a better person, mostly because now that I'm housed, I don't have to put all my time and energy into avoiding harassment from the police. Before we can end the problematic symptoms of the housing crisis, we must first recognize the insidious virus at the root of it, responsible for all the symptoms. That virus is capitalism and greed, but more so the nationwide failure to hold ourselves responsible for being decent human beings who conduct ourselves with integrity and honor. We have become a city and a nation led by elitists who see tax cuts and special privileges for hedge fund billionaires and overblown ridiculous budgets for unjust wars as more important than basic core values and human rights like housing, education, medical care, and a safe and just police response for everyone, not just those with the right racial and economic demographics. Sorry, I'm really nervous right now. Edley needs to recognize how much money he's wasting building concentration camp style shelters like Pier 93, and how much cash he's flushing down the toilet on wages and overtime for an already ridiculously overpaid police force to go out and conduct sweeps, harassing people that he should be focusing on housing. Sometimes fatally even gunning them down in cold blood, as in the case of our dear departed brother Luis Gongora. Tens of hundreds of thousands of dollars that Mayor Lee could be putting into programs that are proven to get people off the streets and into housing, like the San Francisco Homeless Outreach Team. These are taxpayer dollars, and we as taxpayers need to recognize that we have the power to put our foot down and say, Mayor Lee, we need homes for the homeless, not harassment and cold-blooded murder. I myself have repeatedly been a victim from excessive force and brutality from the SFPD regularly while I was homeless. The reality is, if you don't play their game and pretend along with them that their badge grants them supreme omnipotent authority, you get roughed up, choked out, tased, shot, or worse. If you make it clear that you know your rights and won't be bullied, they say you're being combative and uncooperative. How many more scandalous murders of unarmed peaceful citizens will we abide before we come together as a citywide community and let Ed Lee know that we are not going to take it? Not one more. We need to hold the mayor and the SFPD accountable for their actions then, now, and in the future.
Right.
Thanks for your time.
Thank you, Kinsey, for sharing your story with us. Next up, from Poor Magazine, the We Search Policy Group, WPG, is a project of Poor Magazine, Prince of Obre, which is a poor and indigenous people-led, very grassroots, art-based movement. The data they will share with us today was collected by 86 unhoused San Francisco residents dwelling in tents, sleeping bags, and cardboard on 14th Street, Trainer, Cesar Chavez, Freeway, Underpass, and was produced and is being disseminated by the We Search Policy Group. Please welcome them up.
So I have eight scholars here, a member of the We Search Policy Group, so we can get them all over here. Tyree, Kimo, Amir, Zaire. Zaire's the illustrator.
All right.
Give them a big round of applause. I want to point out that I'm holding a copy of Decolonews. Yes, I did say Decolonews, because that's decolonized news. That means not part of the colony. And also, these young people are also students of Decolonized Academy, because we as poor people, indigenous people, refuse to teach our young people the lies that these politricksters continue to use us as disguise. So, first I'm just going to quickly tell you that on our research, we discovered that there was over $56,000, and that was a conservative amount, as they say in the politrickster polls, of the amount of money in just a three-month quarter, stolen, so listen to the word, stolen by the Department of Public Works, funded by the city and the police department. Over a year period since 2014 to now, it was $106,000 in belongings. And to clearly discover, tell you what those belongings were, we're talking about the things that people who have a roof take for granted. We're talking about mementos, pictures, family photos, and we're also talking about jewelry and, like the sister Elaine said, things that we can't ever get back. Things that have no price tag in a capitalist system. Things that once we lose, we are losing something inside of us. But then we're also talking about actual things like computers and hard drives and bicycles and tents and blankets and things and toiletries and pharmaceuticals and drugs that we need to survive, that we get prescriptions for, we can barely pay for. Similarly, what we also discovered in the research was that not only were these belongings taken and stolen, but that we were unable to get them back. And so the key part is, I want people to understand this is a document that we can use. And I just want to say a little bit that we're standing on stolen Ohlone territory right now, Yalamu, that this kind of abuse and colonization happened 525 years ago, that what's happening now is actually no different than what happened then, when poor people and indigenous people and African people were used to build this stolen colony. So really what's happening now is actually just the same circle. And so what I want to put out to all you conscious people in the room and out the room and out of the fake idea of in and out is that we refuse to accept the idea that we don't deserve to have liberated Yalamu Ohlone land. And that actually for unhoused people, I don't really care about what the politricksters say anymore, but rather what we said when they did the Division Street sweeps, which is give us liberated land or we aren't going anywhere. Yeah. Okay, so I just want to keep that up, and I want to invite all of you, because tomorrow we're walking into the rich people neighborhoods where they continue to oppress, test, incarcerate, and arrest us, and giving them an offer for healing from the disease of wealth hoarding and land stealing in capitalist America. Because we're done with asking for their permission. Now we're recognizing that they're sick and they need help. And here we are to give them a little bit of healing and help them take a good way. So I want to invite all of you to come. We're meeting up at Hyde and Union Street, and we'll be going to Knob Hill and Pacific Heights and all the places that they think they're protected. No, we're not doing civil disobedience. My poor ass can't get arrested, and I don't know about the rest of y'all. We're just walking, which is our right, and we're offering a healing program, and we're also meeting some young people who have actually done that. So this is not something that's just a dream and a utopic idea. We teach young folks with race and class oppression that they can be the change. They do not have to continue to work through philanthropists and politricksters to actually kick down their stolen and hoarded wealth or their inherited wealth, that they can open their mind to a concept of redistribution and community reparation. I want to ask if any of our young people want to say something. I don't know if Kimo or Tibu or Tyree. These are all very, very intelligent young folks, and we don't lie to them about what's happening.
Hello. I do not know too much about this. I just recently heard about this, and to see another person die just because he probably wouldn't move, or he probably wouldn't give up his property or any of this stuff, you know, isn't that considered stealing, right?
Yes.
And when you take someone's belongings without the permission, because if I were in that situation where I have my stuff and I'm ready to do something, and just someone randomly tells me that you need to give me all your stuff because it's the law, meaning that I have supreme supreme conquering, I don't know my way of words, but telling you to give me your stuff. I would be offended, I would be defensive, and I would tell you no, and if you were to attack me, I don't be surprised if I would attack back.
Anyone else? I just want to give a big round of applause to our young folks, and thank you all. And let's just recognize that who are the real criminals. That's all I was going to say. Thank you. Thank you. I think we should all learn from it because it's pretty amazing. There we go. Right to rest.
Thank you, Tiny. Thank you, Poor Magazine. And thank you to the brilliant students of Decolonize Academy. I'd like to take this moment to thank all of our brave speakers today for coming and sharing their stories with us and their experiences. Let's give them one more big round of applause, please. Following this horrific recent murder, our demands are straightforward and simple. We are asking for our houseless brothers and sisters to be treated with respect and with dignity that all human beings deserve, for them not to be dehumanized and criminalized by the city for their mere existence. We are demanding a moratorium on these brutal, violent, and inhumane sweeps, and we are also demanding affordable housing for all, immediately. Because we know that Luis Gongora's murder was likely preventable. There was no reason for SFPD to murder him in cold blood. That was absolute excessive force. And we need to hold the police departments accountable for their crimes against our communities. But we also know that had he had the safety of his own home, he would likely be alive and with us today. And so let us come together and call for justice. Let us prevent his life, the loss of his life, being in vain. Join us today for this call for justice. We will be meeting again on Friday, April 29th, and Thursday, May 4th, for community town halls, and flyers available on the Facebook, or flyers are available today, and also the information is on the Facebook page. That's the end of this formal press conference, and Bilal will be coming up to lead the open mic. Oh, and they're also going to do interviews over there. Okay, thank you all for being with us today.
Let's give a hand up to Juliana. All right. Clarion Alley is alive and well today, right? All right. You know, homeless people did not come up with neoliberal policies, right? Homeless people did not create the homeless crisis, right? So quit fucking blaming homeless people for the fucking problems, right? So let's just start off with a little chant, get everybody flowing here. And here at the Homeless Coalition of Homeless, we say, house keys not handcuffed. House keys not. House keys not. House keys not. House keys. House keys. All right, homelessness is not a crime. All right. Y'all ain't winning American Idol and going to Hollywood. Anyway, Hollywood and Western. This is our open mic section here. Many, 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 many times when decisions are made that impact homeless and poor people's lives, homeless and poor people are absent at that table. Homeless people and poor people voices are silent when decisions and policies are being made that impact homeless people's lives. We're changing that culture. We're going to change that culture right now, today. Homeless people voices is usually left out the matrix. It's usually left out the narrative. People who are not homeless are making the decisions. And that's not to disparage people in their house, because we accept and we preach any allies and support, whether you're houseless or not. But homeless people's voices are not out there. We do outreach daily. We just came back from outreach this morning, and people want to tell their story because they're not being listened to, and some of them are here today. So we're going to give that opportunity for homeless people to speak up. So all my homeless and poor folks out there, I'm a homeless and I'm poor, and all of them out there, step up to the mic and you can put your name on the list, but I'm going to have first contestant come on down. We ain't got no homeless people out here. I'm the homeless person out here?
We got one.
All right, come on down. Because I heard you in the street macking. And I know you can mack. All right. He's rolling up in here. Rapping brother, he ain't talking about the bling bling and all that materialist bullshit. He's putting it right down with reality. And as a dedication and commitment to justice, he has now started a hunger strike right across the street at the cop shop. And this is behind regarding the murder by the SFPD of our homeless brother, Luis Gongora. So you guys stop by, visit that brother, talk that brother, giving you support. And if you want to join him in that hunger strike, but he's willing to put his life on the line until the mayor of this city, until the SFPD bow down to the people's will. I'm a former Black Panther, and we always say all power to the people, right? But it's the people that make change, not politicians, not police chiefs, not poverty pimps, and not so-called chosen leaders. It is the people who make history. The people have the power. So that's why we say all power to the people. We want the power to determine our destinies. We do not need outsiders and others who do not have our interests at heart making policy and determine who we are, who we will be, where we will live, and so forth. So it's all power to the people. All power to the people. All power to the people. Our next speaker is... I know. I want you to say it.
All right. Hi, I just wanted to make a short announcement. Speaking of Luis Gongora, a lot of you know, and a lot of you don't know, but Saturday will be the public funeral. So we passed around some flyers. Please spread the word. There will be a family space for grief for his family, but there will be a public funeral. And it's on April 23rd, this Saturday, from 5 to 9 p.m., at Dugan's, 3434 17th Street, which is near Valencia Street. El funeral público de nuestro hermano Luis Góngora Paz se llevará a cabo este sábado, 23 de abril, de 5 a 9 en el Dugan's, y está en este flyer. Thank you.
Thank you, Ava. All right. We have our next speaker. She's still circulating.
Right now we got
Shira from Haya. All right.
My name is Shira Noel. I'm Policy and Advocacy Coordinator with the Homeless Youth Alliance, and I'm also formerly a homeless youth myself. This is Mary.
I'm Mary. I'm the Director of Homeless Youth Alliance, also a formerly homeless person in San Francisco.
When I heard about this shooting, it just broke my heart. It really did. It brought back so many memories of police violence and trying to survive and trying to stay strong with this constant harassment. It's been happening for so long, and it's only getting worse. It's not okay. We have our youth out there. We have our brothers. We have our sisters. We have our mothers. We have our daughters out there dying on the street because of this police brutality. These sweeps are not okay. The destruction of property is not okay, and the taking of lives is not okay. It's not okay.
And I just want to take a minute to address everyone, but especially the allies who have the privilege of living indoors as you do. When you see police harassing the people who are experiencing homelessness on the streets, it is your fucking duty to bear witness to that, to film that, and to say when it's wrong. You have the privilege of not being harassed for merely existing. And it is a powerful thing to bear witness. And to call the cops out on the way they harass people for just being poor and existing on the street, which is not a choice. It is a result of the policies passed within City Hall. That is the reason we have people living on our streets. No one wants to exist on the streets. People want housing. It is a right. And please never allow what happened to Luis to continue to happen. Form a line and stand in the way of that ever happening again. No one should die at the hands of the police, and certainly no one should die within 20 seconds of a police officer getting out of their car for doing absolutely nothing. It is not okay. Exert your privilege and do the right thing. Thank you.
All right, let's give it another hand up for them. We got any?
Good afternoon. I think my dress are in cloth. I don't know if something wrong has happened. But anyway, my name is Miguel Carrera. I'm working in the Coalition on Homelessness a bunch of years. I am formerly homeless. I was staying and sleeping in this street, the Walmart street. I never forgot. So, but one of the things I want to share with you, the very, very first thing is, I would like to make a minute of silence for Luis Gongora and all the people who is killing from the police officers. So, we do? Silence. So I am really sad, and the sadness many times we don't reflect in the faces. The sadness just inside in us, and it's sad because, you know, we are spending all taxes to paying the police officers to doing supposed to a security shared work, but the freaking police officers, they don't have any kind of training.
Yep.
They don't have any kind of capacity. They're so ignorant. And you know that? 20 seconds to killing a human being who was poor and homeless. It's not cool. For me, what I see in there is an ignorance. And we don't need these kind of people. We don't need police officers. If we want to have, we want to create the rules, not the police create the rules in us. The only thing I see, and it's affecting to me, a lot,
being a Latino, brown, they want to be hard, you know? And it's hard for us, because the police want to be always what you think and it's so easily, you know, because I'm working in the Tenderloin, and the police officer says, oh, every day around there. And only because we stopped smoking one cigarette outside in the street, they put a finger to you, only because you're Latino, or only because you're African-American. So we need to abolish the practice of the police officers. We need to stop all these abuses. And we can do it. And we can do it together.
They say get back.
We say fight back.
They say get back.
We say fight back.
They say get back.
We say fight back.
Get back.
Get back.
Get back.
Fight back.
Get back.
We'll change it up. We'll say they say get back. We say fuck that. All right. So any more homeless or formerly homeless speakers want to come up and speak? Because I see some of you here. So that's telling me they getting past the talk and want to walk the walk, right? And so we're going to get past the talk, we're going to walk the walk. We want to thank everyone coming out and supporting this event today. Thank you very much. We're going to close it out like we always like to do with a sense of unity and togetherness through an expression of unity and togetherness. So if everybody can repeat after me, they may beat us.
They may beat us.
They may mistreat us.
They may mistreat us.
They may even cheat us. But they will never defeat us. Why?
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 Because
we're too strong.
We're too strong.
We're too strong.
And we keep on keeping on.
And we keep on keeping on.
Why?
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 Because
we're too legit.
We're too legit.
We're too legit.
We're too legit.
And we're done taking this bullshit. Thank you, everybody.
Thanks again, everyone, for coming out. There's a town hall happening Friday, March 29th at MNRC. Starts at 6 o'clock. We will be discussing this more and more. We will also have another town hall on Thursday, May 4th, and that's going to be focusing on the state of emergency and what's happening here in San Francisco around homelessness. So we hope you'll continue to turn out, continue to fight, stand up for what's right. Thanks again for coming out here today, everybody. And also, happy birthday, Bilal Ali, everybody! Can we sing a little round of happy birthday? Here we go, ready? Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday, dear Bilal, happy birthday to you. And if folks are hungry, we have some sandwiches and granola bars. Just come over here to where the speaker is. Bob's raising his hand. So we'd love to make sure our folks get something to eat. Thanks again.
Hey, Dean.
So if people can check the GoFundMe, or they can give me some cash. We're going directly to their motel room. We're trying to get them inside today.